Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the Nowhere People Next Door written by Happimon Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now this editorial is about the minority community living in Myanmar, and this minority community is the community of Muslims, and this community is known as the Rohingyas community. Now when we look at the demography of Myanmar, it consists primarily of the Buddhists community, and as far as the Muslim community is concerned, it is a minority community living in Myanmar. Now because it is a minority community, it has a distinct culture, it is not liked by the Buddhist community of Myanmar, and Buddhists, they keep on fighting against this Rohingya community. This Rohingya community has been persecuted like hell in Myanmar by this Buddhist community. Now as far as this Muslim community of Rohingyas is concerned, it has been alleged, it has been ascertained by the Buddhist community that this community don't belong to Myanmar, that Rohingyas is a community that has settled in Myanmar illegally. So the key word here is illegally. So this illegal settlement, this illegal migration of the Rohingyas is hated by the Buddhist community. According to the Buddhist community, the country of Myanmar belongs only to the Buddhist community, and this Rohingya community should be thrown out of Myanmar. But when we look into the history of the Rohingyas, now the Rohingyas, they began to settle in Myanmar region from about 15th century. So this is not a modern wave of migration that has took place in migration in Myanmar. Ye aaj kal ki migration nahi hai Rohingyas ki, ki Muslims 100 saal pehle ya 150 saal pehle jaake Myanmar mein settle hue hain, aisa nahi hai. Rohingyas ka jo settlement hai, it began in 15th century. So this is around a 500-600 year old phenomena. But as far as the constitution of Myanmar is concerned, they don't accord place to the Rohingyas in Myanmar, and this is the reason that this community, it keeps on fledging, it keeps on running from one country to another in order to find protection, in order to seek asylum. So Rohingyas is a community that is basically a refugee community. Now this editorial is not basically about Rohingyas. This editorial is more about the response that the world community should give to this issue, the response that should come from India, the response that should come from the global institutions. So first of all, I will be discussing about the role of the global institutions. Now as far as the global institutions are concerned, there is one institution that holds responsibility for the welfare and the peace of this community, and this institution is the institution of United Nations. But United Nations has not been very responsive to the concerns of the Rohingyas community. Now why it has not been responsive? It has not been responsive because most of the world institutions that we have, be that the political institutions or be that the economic institutions, they work as per the cost and the benefit analysis of the global powers. The global powers like United States of America and the various other European countries. Now these countries, they basically decide about how the important global institutions should be working. And the most important institution is the institution of United Nations. United Nations has remained silent. It has not put forward substantive and effective efforts to protect this Rohingya community from the persecution of the by the Buddhists. The second response is from the global powers. Now, as far as China is concerned, China has a well-crafted diplomatic policy with respect to Myanmar. It wants to have a good relationship with the military establishment in Myanmar and also with respect to the parties like National League of Democracy that is led by Suu Kyi. China is not interested in the issue of Rohingyas. It is not interested because according to China, Myanmar is a platform that will help it to have ascendancy over the Indian Ocean and over the South China Sea and also have a say in the East China Sea issue. So it wants to don't disturb its relationship with Myanmar. And as far as India is concerned, India has also not been very proactive with respect to Rohingyas. Now in examination, you can get a question about what is India's response with respect to Rohingyas. Recently, India has put up on the anvil the law about conferring citizenship to the minorities like the Sikhs, like the Jains, like the Hindus living in its neighbor countries. India believes that it is its duty to protect these minority religion. But in the list of the minority religions, India has not included Muslims as the minority religion. Now, by doing this, India is actually going against its own spirit of the constitution. India is actually going against its own value system of the constitution. India should try to do away with this wrong by including also the Muslims under the list of the minorities which needs protection shall be provided by India. Because if India will be doing that, it will help India to improve its soft image. Because if you want to become a global power, you don't only need the hard image to be strengthened, but you also need your soft image also to be strengthened. Because it is the cumulative effect of the soft image plus the hard image that helps you to rise high in the pedestal in order to become a global power. Now, when it comes to the issue of refugees, now this topic can also be asked in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 4, like the issue of the refugees and the rights of the citizenships. Now, as far as India is concerned, India has not signed United Nations Convention on Refugees. Therefore, it is not an obligation on part of India to accept the refugees belonging to this Rohingya community. Now, as far as the issue of the refugees is concerned, at the core lies the interest of a citizen belonging to a nation, belonging to a state. And on the other hand, we have the refugees. These refugees, they don't belong to any nation, they don't belong to any state, but they belong to mankind. They belong to humanism. They belong to the entire earth. These refugees are the global citizens, and these global citizens must also have a right to stay on any piece of land in the earth. And in order to protect their interests and in order to protect their rights, it is must that the states should be protecting them. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainy IAS. You can find this application from Google Play Store and from App Store. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.